The factory discharged wastewater and several children died of leukemia, apparently related to water quality issues. The parents hired a lawyer, but when the lawyer investigated the factories on the ground, he smiled a treacherous smile because he intended to make a big profit. He saw that the two factories were financially strong, but the results were not what he expected. The lawyer ends up with a huge debt and he is determined to pursue justice and fight for those poor children. This story is based on a true event that took place in the movie Edge of the Law. It takes place around a lawyer named Jane, who leads a small team of lawyers who started with nothing and are not only dedicated to winning cases, but also specialize in getting higher settlements, fighting for the plaintiff's damages under the banner of justice and earning themselves lucrative attorney's fees as well. Jane also shares his legal knowledge on the radio from time to time, offering free legal advice to the public, and he has thus embarked on a life of wealth, owning designer suits and sports cars, and has been voted by Boston Magazine as one of Boston's top 10 golden bachelors. One day, however, Jane receives a call from a woman named Annie, whose son died of leukemia 2 years ago, a case that seems unprofitable, but since it's on the air, Jane agrees to Annie's request and travels to the town to investigate. In the town, he learns that there have been 12 leukemia deaths in 15 years, 8 of which were children. Parents suspect that water quality has something to do with these tragedies, but the law firm isn't willing to take the case. Since it was a live case, Jane had to accept it and meet with the parents. The parents were not seeking monetary compensation, they just wanted to know the truth, get an apology, and make sure this type of incident never happened again. Jane explains the financial pressures on the law firm, but promises to investigate to the best of her ability. In the course of what follows, Jane discovers two factories discharging sewage, and attorney Jerry and attorney Kiki appear in court on behalf of the factories. They make a settlement offer, but Jane is adamant that he will not accept it because he believes this is a case of fighting for justice. He continued his investigation and found evidence to support the allegations of sewage discharge from the factories. However, Jane's legal team gradually fell into financial difficulties and had to take out a loan to continue the investigation. The parents also began to feel the pressure, but they kept their faith and hoped to find the truth. Eventually, through the court's efforts, the factory was charged with polluting the water and ordered to pay for the cleanup. Anne and the other parents did not receive monetary compensation, but they received justice and reassurance, and the plant was forced to close. Jane eventually went on to pursue environmental law, and he still practices justice and helps victims advocate for their rights.